we are having these as habits. One habit like this, one habit like this, one habit like this. This come from us, to us, from our behavior in the previous birth. Yes, if the habit is through births, we call it karma. If the habit is through years, like coffee, we call it habit. No difference. It is only a difference of degree and intensity. Suppose I want coffee, I want opium, I want LSD, that is some drugs, narcotics, etc. Yes. Suppose daily I take them, then you put me here and lock, and you don't allow me to take those things. Yeah. One thing. Second, another person. He daily goes to persons like this, Sri Aurobindo, or some mystic, or some Mahatma. Then the R goes to into the Alps mountain, high up. Daily goes and sees the sunrise and sunset, comes to daily. And in another room, you lock him also and don't allow him to go. What happens? For me, the first day it will be a hell. I don't get my coffee in time, headache, I don't get my opium in time, head reeling, alcohol, much trouble. 24 hours, I suffer very, very much. Next day, also I suffer, but less. Third day, less. After 1 month, much less. Only a memory of those things, not suffering. After 2 months, a humorous memory of those things, laughing at them. We laugh to ourselves that I was like this, I was dying without opium, I was dying without coffee like that. Then, what about the other person? It is different. See, daily he was going to Sri Aurobindo, or some great mystic, or to a music, going to a music musician, or going to art, to see art pictures, artist. You didn't allow him. What happens? He sits in the room and mentally thinks of it. Today, so much. Tomorrow, he thinks more of it. Yes, yes, he can remember better. You see, suppose one of your relatives goes to America, a son or somebody, husband or son going to America for 1 year. First day, you will have astral thoughts about him, that is worry and sorrow. Second day, less worry but more memory. After 1 month, remembering him very well, very fresh, very fine, but not sorrow. So, nature strengthens good habits and decreases bad habits if we cooperate. If we do this experiment, the same thing will happen. Suppose some government in some country imprisons a man who is thinking of God. What happens? He is not unhappy. He goes into his moods more and more. Suppose a good government imprisons a man who is eating opium. Daily he gets out of it. He never goes into it. For a few days he goes into it. The first few days, he thinks very deeply about it. This is the help of nature to man. That is, these are typical examples. By understanding these, we can study those advanced and complicated examples later.
All right.
So I am explaining you principles.
Yes.
I say, then suppose after 1 month, after 2 months or 3 months, you bring strong coffee there. I am in this room, and you open the bottle. I get the smell. Then what happens? It stimulates. If there is any thought to drink coffee. Any, if there is any desire remaining still left, these planets do the same thing in us daily. They stimulate, they try to stimulate and bring out the past, the effect of the past karmas as tendency. So, if the lower mind, if the lower mind is active, it is the mind of reaction, lower mind, mind of reaction, reaction. If it is active, you will react with other people. Then these outer results of the mundane astrology will happen, will be true. They will occur. Your predictions will be correct. That is, the more the mundane or the more animal nature the man is having, the more correct will be your prediction. Because you will be able to predict under such circumstances, how he behaves. Suppose he lives in the higher mind, higher mental. That is, it is not a mind of reactions, but it is a mind of neutralization. See, always there is a polarity between two persons, which we call difference of personality. By living in the higher mind, we will neutralize the polarity with everyone. The Tibetan master explains in the esoteric astrology these things very well. Tibetan master, that is L. C. A. Bailey, in the esoteric astrology, these are discussed very well. The secret, I'll tell you one secret about it. We like to think that it is not easy, because our past tendencies make us believe like that. Yes, because they want their habits to continue. We know that there is no use of worry, but we want to get worried. That is the strength of these tendencies of the lower pole. But their weak point is the lower tendencies have a grip only on the physical and astral body. For example, laziness. I place my body here. Laziness is not to the body. Laziness is not to the body. Mind wants to think that it cannot lift the body now. There are some patients, that is disease, patients who want to lie on the bed for longer time, because others do service to them. It is very hard. They believe that they are weak and that they cannot get up. Yes. If such a person is alone in a room and nobody there, if the house is burning, what happens? The lower mind gets absorbed, the higher mind gets the stimulation for a minute, he jumps up. See, we have two minds in our lower mind. One is routine mind.
Routine.
Daily we do the work with routine mind, because we want to be lazy. We need not think. For routine, we need not think. To have breakfast in the 8 p.m., we need not think. No originality is required. No intelligence is required. To go to the office punctually, no originality is required. So the routine mind does all these things. The original mind is not used. We are not using the original mind.
The original mind.
Original mind. The creative mind. Second half of the lower mind. No, in the lower mind, there are two halves.
Yes.
First half is routine mind. Routine mind. Second half is original mind. Suppose a man working here is taken into sleep and taken to India or America, placed there. What happens? He gets up in India. Suppose a man is made to sleep here, given chloroform, made unconscious, closed his eyes and all that, taken to India, the language not known, the place not known, nothing is known. We leave him there and come away. But what happens? But very, very difficult he feels. Suppose you leave an animal like that, an ant like that. Any animal, lower animal, what happened? No difficulty with it, at least much less difficulty. Yes, because the
routine
animal is using the routine mind, and also it is using the other mind also. Second part of the lower mind, because he loses the habit of using the original mind, he finds it very difficult there. But within few hours, he tries to live, tries to do something, tries to imitate somebody there, and after a few days, he tries to learn things. That is the only time when his original mind grows, develops. See, in the routine, his original mind is not at all developing, because he is not using. in situations that are trying and testing, horrifying, the original mind develops. That is why nature arranged in such a way, for every action there is a result. For every unknown action there is a bad result. A bad result, some suffering, inconvenience. With suffering and inconvenience, our original mind awakens. It is an automatic computer mechanism. Yes, yes. We create suffering by our wrong things, doing wrong. We experience suffering, and this purifies us, we rectify ourselves.
Yes. Out of suffering we learn.
Yes, yes. Because the original mind begins to work.
Yes.
That is why man getting difficulties and these things. So everything, nature has got an art of using every bit of life. Everything is useful. For a fool, there are many useless things in this world. If you take a fool into the forest, he says, all these trees are wild trees. But for a doctor who uses herbs, a remedy for some disease, like this, nature is a big doctor. This relationship between nature and man, the spiritual astrology gives. So, there are no predictions in spiritual astrology. Only a good advice to follow, which works as an initiation for a new path. So that is the purpose. That is the purpose of the higher astrology. Yes, yes, I'll tell you, I'll explain. Yes, return is the same. Yes, 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 I'll tell you why. I'll tell you. Animal is guided by nature, that is appetite, eating. When tired, it sleeps. When active, it goes. So every movement guided by nature. Yeah. But man is between man and nature. Man has created another world, that is his own creation. For example, languages. He has prepared his own code for himself. Man, yes. So animals have only nature's creation or God's creation.
Yes.
Man has nature's creation, and within that, around man, man's creation.
Yes.
Because, yes, because man is also an animal, but also a creator. Animals are not creators.
Yes.
They have no creative mind. For example, man created money. No, no, whether good or bad, he has created a world of his own. That is his knowledge. His knowledge, if his knowledge is different from the nature's knowledge, it gives suffering. This is the meaning of eating the fruit of the tree of knowledge. Fall of man. Before man ate this fruit of knowledge, he was happy. That is what the Bible says. But God has forbidden that fruit for man to use against nature. Because there is reproduction in trees. If man is working in the fields and forests, the trees give their give him food by their multiplication. He need not use a machine. If you have good trees, what progress? If you want your own progress, you must be responsible for your own good and bad. Why? Primitive means, yes, without machines. Well, certainly, man wants machines. It develops into the secrets of nature. Mind. Because how could the mind grow first into the senses? At first there was no physics, there was no chemistry, there was no mathematics. How could the mind of the first man grow? The mind of the first scientist discover the first discovery. Because they are there in nature, he has discovered it. So man can go into nature without complicating his own creation. Man can very much develop science without having his own disadvantages. Because he is developing disadvantages also with his development of science. Yes. Suppose he discovers unnecessary things. Yes. When there are rivers flowing, man used to drink water directly from the rivers or with a vessel like that. Therefore, he could have water 24 hours. Mm-hmm. Suppose we will direct a river into cities, into water works. Suppose the water work fails. Like that, man should understand that by stimulating nature's forces, he is doing some wrong things also to cause harm to himself. No, no, thousands of people can live even with rivers, ponds and canals. What about the availability and non-availability when the control is with a few persons? When a few persons control the water of all the thousands of people of the city, mm-hmm. there is a risk of failure. Like that, he can use mechanization, but too much mechanization leads into risk of his own disadvantage. It is not bad. Creation is not bad. If he creates, his creation is against the laws of nature, it is a false law of nature. Yes, by seeing the animals and plants, we can very easily understand the law of nature. Yes. There is no trouble at all. He gets all the advantages of animals and plants, and also the advantage of man being a creator. Yes. He can be happy, and not only that, he can keep animals, plants and others, all everything happy. He can live happy life. He can create happiness also.
Yes, that is true.
Knowledge is not dangerous. Knowledge.
Yes.
In the Bible also it is said that the tree of knowledge is dangerous. Tree of knowledge, the fruit of you fruit means the result of our action. Knowledge. Because fruit means the result. Motive. If man works for motive,
yes,
it is dangerous.
Only motive.
Suppose I make people cultivate my land and take the wheat into my house, give them something and keep this for selling. That is what we do. Mm-hmm. That is what Egypt did in Old Testament when there was fall of Egypt. And that is exactly what the modern civilization is doing.